Hello, the following is a short video for the plant breeding practicum course and describes the process of transgene testing for cotton plants. So what are transgenes? Transgenes are genes or any genetic material that have been transferred from one organism to another, either naturally or by using genetic engineering techniques. Testing for transgenes is important in plant breeding because transgenes are patented and cannot be used by non-license holders. Using transgenes, intentionally or unintentionally, can result in lawsuits. This procedure is usually done before making any new crosses between plants. If any plant contains any transgene not patented by the breeder, it is immediately eliminated from the plant breeding process. This is a quick and simple test for cotton plants and requires the following: a sample of a young leaf of the plant being tested, a transgene testing kit containing testing strips and a buffer, a microcentrifuge machine, append-off tubes, a pipette, pestles, pipette tips, and gloves. The strips are selected according to specific proteins like Cryvan F, Bolgard 2, or Roundup Ready. For this demonstration, a strip for the detection of Cryvan F protein will be used. The sample is collected from a young leaf, and the tube is open and the leaf is placed between the lid and the tube. It is then closed and detached from the plant. So I have now collected the sample and we have to add the buffer to it. Taken a 200 microliter pipette and I have to add 400 microliters of the extraction buffer to the sample. We are using the extraction buffer that is provided in the kit. After adding the buffer, we'll take a pestle and grind the sample into the buffer so that the proteins are extracted from the leaf. Make sure to grind the sample thoroughly. After grinding the sample, we let it rest for 30 seconds, after which we centrifuge the samples. We just have to centrifuge for about 1 minute at 4000 RPM. After centrifuging, you can see that the debris has settled down nicely. Now we open our tubes, and the last thing to do is to just place the testing strips into the samples. So these are the strips are then removed and placed on a white background to view the results. This is an image showing the testing done for a crossing block. There is a control line which appears in all strips. Any mark that appears below this line is an indicator for a transgene. This is what a strip would look like if it contained one of the transgenes being tested, and this is what it looks for three. Usually this test is performed for field plants rather than greenhouse plants. Since fields contain a lot more plants, samples are collected on ice to prevent protein degradation due to heat. Also, pools of around 12 plants are tested together rather than individual plants to make the process simpler. If any pool contains transgenes, then individual plants from that pool are tested again and the plant containing the transgene is eliminated. That is all for transgene testing. I hope this was helpful. Thank you.